Navigating night weaning. How do you know when your baby's ready? And how do you actually go from lots of feeds in the night, or even one feed in the night, to actually getting rid of those night feeds? How do you know when the time is right, and how do you actually do it? Well, I'm going to share with you four keys and questions you need to ask yourself to actually go through this night weaning navigation. The first thing is determining whether or not your baby is ready. Is your baby ready? How do you know? It varies so much from baby to baby. There isn't a set rule for this. So it's about knowing your child and when your child is ready. You see babies at just 3 months who can sustain the whole night without needing any milk. You see others take milk on board in the night till they're closer to a year old. So there really can be a big variation in readiness. Is your baby growing, putting on weight as expected? Are there any concerns around weight? Because if so, it may be that your baby needs to take on some milk for a bit longer in the night. If your baby is growing perfectly well, totally healthy, no weight concerns, taking on board substantial calories in the day, and you haven't got any worries there, then that's one great tick in the right box for being ready for night weaning. So that's one thing you want to make sure of before you approach this. The other one is to think about those wakings in the night. Maybe you don't have any, but if you do, and working out whether those are hunger wakings or not. It's a common misconception to assume that every time a baby wakes in the night, they must be hungry, so you must go feed it. And that's not true. It might be that your baby's just waking, because we all wake in the night, and it may be that you just get a wake up that requires a bit of comfort, a bit of reassurance. Perhaps your baby's going, oh no, I'm awake, I don't know how to get back to sleep, I need some help. But it doesn't mean I'm hungry automatically. Of course, a feed might satisfy your baby. They might take it and go, brilliant, thanks, and go back to sleep. And that will have you believe that they were hungry. In actual fact, they possibly weren't hungry. They just needed something, and that's what they're used to, and that's the trigger they've got used to, and that's what got them back off to sleep that time. But it doesn't automatically mean it was hunger. And you can check out more information on that on another episode, but it's a really useful tool in identifying whether or not your baby really is hungry in the night, and also, you know, knowing whether that weight gain is okay and you're in the right place for moving on to night weaning. So if you feel totally confident that, yep, I believe my baby's only waking for comfort reasons, I don't believe there's hunger in the night, we're stuck in a rut of feeding in the night when we probably really don't need to be, what can I do about this, and how can I get either claw back those night feeds, or so either reduce them or get rid of them altogether. How do you do that? So the first thing you need to do is choose an approach. What do I mean by an approach? It's an approach to night weaning. Are you going to go cold turkey with this, or are you going to reduce those night feeds gradually? And again, there isn't a right or wrong here. It depends on your child and your situation and how that child's best going to handle this transition. For older ones, if you know we're talking about, I don't know, a 2.5-year-old that still has a bottle in the night, for example, then you know for sure that that is a habit, it's a comfort thing, and actually you can't really ease that away. You need to just get rid of it, bring in a new form of comfort, and stick with it. That would be a cold turkey scenario. Another scenario where you would probably take things more gradually is where perhaps there's a little uncertainty around hunger, or perhaps your child just needs easing off of the milk, a baby, a younger one, in which case you want to take things more gradually. And it could just be down to your personality and your baby's personality as to whether you feel like, you know, crisp, clear, total certain boundaries, or whether you need to just move things along gradually. So choose the approach that's right for you, that's right for your child, and you know, stick with that. Now, once you've done this, so you've decided that your baby's ready, you've decided on approach, you now need to ask yourself a question. Is this going to be a no more feed scenario? Or is this going to include a feed? Is it going to be one feed? So is this a get rid of feeds, or is this a reduce the feeds path that you're on? Let's look at, first of all, the getting rid completely. So if you're on the path of no more feeds, then my advice to you is that you stick to that, no more feeds. So you draw a line in the sand and you say, okay, we're not going to be feeding in the night from now on. You've decided that that's okay. You've decided your child doesn't need the feeds, that it's just become a habit, so you're going to not feed in the night anymore. This is pretty much cold turkey. So if you've decided that and there's no more feeds, you need to basically close up shop on the milk. Now, whether that means there's a last little milk intake at bedtime as part of the bedtime routine, there's some milk, maybe then toothbrush or whatever it might be, and then down to bed, then that needs to be it. No more milk until morning, and you need to stick to your guns on that. If there are wakings, you need to meet those wakings with reassurance, comfort, whatever your approach is, whatever your response is, and do that consistently. That consistent response is key. There's no going back. If you take this approach, you want to keep going with this. If you basically deny your child milk for the first time, and at 10 p.m. they wake up and they want it because it's what they used to, and you're like, no, it's not happening, and then they go back to sleep, and you think, brilliant, I did it, great. And then at 2 a.m. you get the same again, and then maybe at 4 a.m. you get the same again, but this time you've had enough, you're tired, you're at a particularly groggy stage in your night's sleep, and you just decide that, oh, fine, go on, have it, and you cave in. All you're going to do is teach a child that the more they protest, the longer they hold out, that eventually you're going to give in. So you need to be sure first, but once you are sure, then stick to your guns and see it through. Don't doubt yourself, don't second guess yourself, see it through. You'll know soon enough if you've made a mistake and your child is actually genuinely hungry. The chances are, though, if you've done these checks and you're certain, then you're on the right path. So now let's look at the other scenario. In the scenario where you're doing a milk reduction and you've decided that you're weaning the night feeds, and it, you know, there may still be a feed in there, but so you're not getting rid of them completely, but you definitely want to work through this, then here are my tips for you. First of all, decide how many. If you're even going down the path of night weaning, then I would suggest it will only probably be one, at the most two feeds in the night. Otherwise, you're just still night feeding, in which case we're probably in the newborn stage in the first 3 months. But if you are doing this, it will probably be one or two. So decide how many. And then also you want to decide how you're going to deliver that feed. Is it going to be a dream feed or a response feed? What do I mean by that? So a dream feed is where you take the feed to the baby without them asking for it. They don't wake up, cry, and a feed comes. That's a response. So what happens is they're asleep. You've timed it. You've made a decision that at this point is about the right time for my baby, for the hunger. And you go in, you feed them in their sleep, or maybe they rouse and they're a bit awake and they take it half awake, or maybe they wake up fully. It doesn't matter. The point is, of a dream feed, doesn't have, people think dream feed means they're asleep the whole time. Not necessarily. They can be, but not necessarily. It just means that your baby didn't wake up, cry, and get milk as a response to the cry. The feed came to them. So that's what a dream feed looks like. And if that's the case, it really doesn't matter if your baby stays asleep the whole time, wakes up, falls back asleep, goes down asleep after the feed, it doesn't matter because it's a dream feed. If it's a response feed, then you've decided it's a response feed. So you're not gonna go in and try to settle your baby, but if it doesn't work, you feed, because that's kind of a fallback. This is a response feed. It's that, baby's awake, first waking after midnight, that's a response feed. And you go in intentionally to feed straight away. You don't make them wait, you don't make them try to settle. You just go, no, this one's a feed. You go in straight away, purposefully feed. But the key with a response feed is that you make sure your little one is awake at the end of the feed. They go back down awake and practice the self-settle. What's really important is that you don't do a response feed to sleep. Make sense? So you're not going to, baby wakes up, they cry, you respond with a feed and you feed your baby back to sleep. That's really not going to be helpful at all going forward. I mean, that's going to just really push a reliance on milk to get to sleep, and that's not what you want at all, and it's not going to help with the night weaning either. So make sure if you do a response feed, it's a response feed. You respond, you feed, baby stays awake, resettle to sleep, and then there's nothing wrong with a response feed if it's done like that. So decide what you're going to do, dream feed or response feed. Now you might like to do something like where you reduce the quantity of the milk that you give, or the time that baby's feeding on the breast, for example. So it could be an amount thing, and you might want to reduce that down. That's another approach you can use, and do that in steps. Anything like that, if you're gonna, and another thing people do actually is with bottle fed babies, whether it be breast milk or formula milk in the bottle, but with bottle fed babies, some people might choose to just water it down a bit. So actually you're diluting the taste, and therefore baby's getting less interested, and then you find that actually they're not that bothered and it was just more of a comfort thing. Those are all options, and you know, different people find different things suit them better, and that's fine. But the key to doing that, if you are going to reduce the quantity, the quality or the time of the feed, is to make sure you keep moving. Set a pace of momentum. By that I mean, is it going to happen over a certain amount each night for the next 4 or 5 nights or a week? Like, make sure that over the course of a week you've got a time frame of movement so that you're progressing all the time, you know, a little bit each night, or maybe a bigger step every 2 days or something, that over the course of a week you get from A to B. Don't do a bit and then linger there for days on end, because you need to make the decision, set the pace and work through it. That's really, really key if you're going to do this gradually. Don't hold out too long or drag it out too long. So there you go, my tips for you on navigating this complex thing of night weaning. And I can tell you the toughest bit, the absolute toughest bit, is the very first thing I told you, which is your baby ready? And how do you even know if your baby's ready? Sometimes you don't know, and you have to just go with your instincts and test it. And just go, well, do you know what? I think that I'm only getting wakings for comfort, but I'll tell you what, we'll, benefit of the doubt, we'll factor in a dream feed. Just before you go to bed, factor in a dream feed and test it, and just see if actually that holds things off till morning, and you can respond with reassurance for the other night wakings. And you do need a plan for that. You do need to decide on what your reassurance plan response looks like, so that you can respond to the other wakings in a really conducive way to helping your baby sleep soundly. So I hope that's helped you, and if you've enjoyed this episode, if you found it helpful, don't forget to click the link that you'll find somewhere around this video, which will take you to a really helpful handout on this topic. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and make sure you get those notifications for any new episodes we release. And if you have a friend that you think this would really, really help, tag them, share it with them. Let's pay it forward and help as many parents as we possibly can.